Right then, what's going on? Ooh, nice. I even got snowflakes in my phone. If only I could have such dynamic wallpaper on my actual phone, but that would probably like heat up my phone and it would destroy it. Okay. What's going on downstairs? Horrific drama is unfolding before me. I never expected such a frightening uproar. Cheer up. Gah, I won't be swayed by honeyed words. I won't let you mock the fact that my blog is under attack. All I did was praise my film critiques under another name. Just a little bit of acting. Somehow the internet found out and hates me now, and the jeers get worse when I explain myself. Perhaps this is a sign. Perhaps I'll move on from critiquing films to the next stage of my career. I'll be going home then. God. Actual soy boy. Crossing space-time, the Phoenix Rangers unite their powers as one. Will they be able to return to their original worlds, revive, and fight? Okay. Anything about the weather, Sojido?
Yeah.
Shido guy always seemed like a cunning ass. I never thought things would end up like this. Me too. Takemi Ryuji. Shinya. Well, honestly... Oh, Makoto. Well, that's an easy one. Did she text me? No, she didn't. Okay. So, what are you gonna do? Aiko had a favor. Do you think you could maybe come with me to see her? Sure thing.
Shall we go?
He's over at Big Bang Burger. All right, let's do it.
Is something the matter?
So what did you want to talk about? So like I ordered a large coffee, but this is a small coffee. Can you even get anything right, Makoto? God damn it. I was wondering if you could maybe lend me some cash. Ooh. Ooh, that is the reddest of reddest flags, you know? Like, that is a fucking... Oof. Now, if someone ever comes to you and tells you that, whether it's a friend or a family member, immediately cut them off. Ooh. You don't want to deal with that shit, ever. It's nothing really major. I needed it, like, right now. I'll pay you back though, honest, please. This is the classic scam where it's like, I need money to pay back something, and then you'll never get that money back, and that person's in like deep shit. And it just perpetuates, and they'll ask money from other contacts, and then they gotta pay back someone, and they borrow money to pay back the other person, and then it's like, oh, you know, what the fuck's going on here? Does this have to do with Tsukasa? Mm-hmm. He dropped a super expensive bottle of sake at work, so the club's been making him pay for it, but he needs help.
How suspicious.
He's lying to you, Aiko. Don't give him any money. He's not lying. I know you're all weird about the fact that he's a host, but my Tsukasa's not like that. He's a real gentle and honest, too. He even calls me princess. I'm the only one who says that, too, you know? He says it's because I'm special. So, he calls you his special princess. What do you think, MC-kun? Alright, well, let's be considerate of her position and her emotional state. Just kidding, I don't care. You break up with him. He says that to all his girls. Oh, looks like we can actually be brutally honest here. Go with that?
Yes.
I have to agree. Every girl who gives him money is his princess. Well, there can be multiple princesses. What's wrong with that? Polygamy. The way he can never get their names mixed up. Ooh, smart. Don't accuse him of that stuff. You don't have any proof. You're not wrong about that.
But
did you ask anyone at the club about the broken bottle? Well, no. He told me not to talk to them about it, though. He's too proud to have me go crying to his boss. Please, Makoto, you're the only person I can trust. All my other friends would rather focus on cram school and entrance exams than take time to help me. Who knows what my parents say if I try to ask them. Please, even a little. You're getting 5 cents. think you should end your relationship with them. If you don't put a stop to this, he might try to drag you into some suspicious line of work. Oh, he already got me a job. It's nothing weird, though. I'm just serving drinks at a bar to help him pay off that broken bottle. He said I'll be number one in no time. Maybe I'll just keep doing it after I graduate high school, though. I mean, it's not like I'm gonna go to college. Eiko, you can't just do what he says. He's trying to deceive you. A smart person like you totally wouldn't understand what it's like. You're just gonna go to a good college, work at a fancy company, and then what? At the end of the day, your life's gonna be totally boring. I mean, is that seriously how you want to live? Rejecting much? I'm not sure yet. But be that as it may, you should still stay as far from him as you can. So you're not gonna help me? Ugh, just forget it. I can make it up if I just let the customers take me out on dates after work. Eiko, wait. This is why I don't have friends. I don't like fucking dealing with other people's problems. Because people who have problems are problems. And guess what? As your own person, you have enough problems to deal with. Why stay far away from people? I don't want to have to tell you this, but Tsukasa has been texting me almost constantly. Recently, he's been asking if my sister and I live alone, that he'd be glad to help us out. Even today, he asked me if I'm still happy with my boyfriend. Listen to me, Aiko. He's not serious about you. Don't give me that crap. Tsukasa's just so nice that he'd worry about my friends for me. Wait, you were texting him behind my back? What the hell, Makoto? It was mostly him texting me. Ugh, you have the grades, the looks, a cool boyfriend, and you seriously still want more? The thing is that this type of conversation is incredibly realistic, where like, the accused, it becomes so the self-victim becomes so absorbed in their own current situation that it is actually impossible to understand another individual and their positioning, because you're just so psychologically mind-fucked that you are not even operating as a human being. You are just autonomously responding to things, and that's scary, because that's when you lose all sense of self, which Aiko is here. You can't take him from me.
Please listen.
That's not what I'm trying to do. Yeah, right. Just keep your hands off. I'll never forgive you if you stole him away, Makoto. Tsukasa is all she has. You know, I think she's exactly the kind of girl those gangs in Shinjuku are on the lookout for. Lonely, depressed girls who have nowhere to vent their frustrations. I mean, I don't think she's lonely because she has other friends and she has parents. It's just that she's developed self-helplessness, in which she's kind of put herself in this psychological state where she cannot ask anybody for help but Makoto, because her pride won't let her go to her parents. All of her friends have basically, like, they probably told her it's a scam too. So everybody's kind of telling her, oh, you know, like, this is a scam, but she just won't listen because she's so self-absorbed, basically. So I don't think she's depressed, just, like, she has made this her only option. I forgot what the term is for that, though. Help, Tsukasa. Eiko's family is quite well off. Yeah, which is, like, you're not, like, what do you mean? Like, I don't get why she socially compares herself to Makoto, because if she's also well off, then how does that also affect her chances to go to college or whatnot, you know? I mean, it sucks to say this, but it doesn't matter if you're stupid. If you have money, you can go to any college you want. That's just the truth of it. You can buy your way in. Money rules the world. I mean, it's shitty, but it's the truth. So she could go to college and she could, you know, get an education and get a good job and whatnot. So I don't really see, like, the argument she was making there, but I guess in the sense of how her self-esteem would be affected by that method, maybe. But I guess that's not really important in this case. We're focusing on the boyfriend aspect. Her multi-talented younger brother seems to be the sole focus of her parents' attention, though. Ah, I see. I'm sure that's why she fell for Tsukasa in the first place. He treats her like she's special. But asking a high schooler for money isn't normal boyfriend behavior. I would say asking, like, that's the thing. I feel like if anybody ever asked to, like, borrow money for you, there has to be a better damn reason that can be explicitly stated the moment that it happens. Like, let's say I genuinely forget my wallet or whatever, right? My friend pays for my dinner or whatever. I will do everything I can to immediately pay him back as soon as possible. Because the moment you create what are called depths of gratitude, the more you do not know the unconditional consequences or psychological type of perceptions that the other individual has because of that debt. Some people take debts very seriously. Some people don't. Certain cultures do. Certain social circumstances do. Certain in-groups do as well. And you have no idea how another person feels about a debt of gratitude. So that's why, like, just how I view it. You should never be in debt to someone because you have no idea how the other person is treating the severity of it. Moving on. She needs you to realize that you're going to help, right? Eh, she deserves him. Well, you know what they say, misery loves misery. It sucks to say, but negative people attract negative people. What are we gonna do, though? Not entirely sure yet. I doubt I'll be able to do it alone. Eiko's blessed to have both money and a family, yet she's still trying to break free from them. She's almost the exact opposite of me. But I guess in a sense, watching her now is almost like looking back at my past self. I was so blinded by my own convictions that I never stopped to consider other alternative viewpoints of the world. But that's not the right way to live. I want to show her that, just like you did for me. Interesting.
All right.
We shall soon see. I know she wants to stay out of her business, but I never forgive myself if I let this come to pass. What is the right way to live? At any rate, we're going to catch that horrible host. I'll let you know once I've thought of how to do it.
I'll see you later.
Sounds good. The plot thickens. Isn't that Shido guy amazing? I don't know much about politics, but I like Shido. This is the first time I felt like voting. I read that as vomiting. I was really moved when I heard this speech. He's gonna be prime minister, right? That's so cool. Yeah, that's rad.
Ah, you're back.
I am indeed. And Hifumi will not leave me alone. But my bond will grow stronger with her. So it seems we will most likely do that. Yeah. Honestly, if she wasn't going to hang out with me, I would have just played darts. My thinking gets sharper on rainy days. The sound of raindrops increases my focus. Alright, let's do it.
Thank you very
much. Morgan's like, nobody thinks you're alive. Remember that. Thanks you. I look forward to it. Okay.
Check.
You have been defeated. The battlefield is mine. The ultimate Togo kingdom is complete. All of my pieces have been taken. Hifumi has left me utterly defeated. But to think you could stay standing after being struck by my silver infinity sword. You've improved considering that you endured the climbing silver so early in the match. Your determination I'm sensing from you is a real inspiration. I must think of a new move. I'm afraid you'll surpass me one day if I don't stay sharp.
Actually,
the exhibition match against the pro my mother was talking about has been confirmed. He's a very famous shogi player, aiming to be the first woman to reach the pro ranking league. I'm sure it will draw a lot of attention, especially after the article. However, I don't intend to lose. This is my chance to display my true skills. I confess, I'm a bit scared though. Don't let your guard down. I won't. My opponent is ranked much higher than I am, so I won't take him lightly. To be honest, I'm not sure how well my skills will hold up against a true professional.
All right.
But I'm sick of being treated like an idol. I have to to show them what I'm made of. Give it your all then. I will. No, there's a move I want to try out. Would you like to play another match?
Thank you very much.
Strategically place your pieces in the enemy zone to increase your chances of getting gold. Be sure to use that tactic in your next match. For today, try and steal the pieces you want from me. Yeah, but placing them in enemy territory too, like, they can just kill the piece that you just place automatically too. Earn double money if a battle is won in one turn.
Alright.
What? Okay. Cool. We always like money. Well then, let's begin the match. I hereby place this golden mantle upon the shoulders. Don it with pride.
I'll start.
Come, lightning metamorphosis, gold promotion. Oh, I was hoping it'd play an animation.
Thank you for today.
Okay.
Hey.
I will continue slacking until there is nothing to do. It may be a Sunday, but that time of relaxation is ruined by all of the noise outside. Yep, no matter where I go, I keep hearing election speeches. It'd be fine if that was all. Cheeto's calling himself a brave hero who stood up to vile terrorists. Don't make me laugh, he's nothing but rotten scum. It seems he's been using the Phantom Thieves as ammunition for his political activities. Only 2 weeks until election. And it's been exactly 2 weeks since the news of MC's suicide. We should probably hurry. I'll probably be killed if they learn he's still alive. I'll be careful. MC's safety is vital. We will hold back nothing in order to help out. Just give word when you're ready, and we'll all come over.
I have something.
Oh. Scared me for a bit. What's the plan for today? Okay. And how do we... Okay. Utaba will go up. Yusuke and Makoto will not. And Kasumi. I swear, if Kasumi gets like 5 extra bonds, I'm gonna be like, oh my god. I got more to do. Why are you here again? Oh, it's just same old shit, okay. The Phantom Thieves are old news, nice. We're only halfway through election season, but it seems the victor is already clear. The United Front, led by Mr. Shido, has been dominating the other parties. Victory seems certain for them, and people have high hopes about having a new Prime Minister. As for Mr. Shido himself, he was once again out giving speeches and...
Now then!
He won't, don't worry. I'll make sure of it.
Hey!
Be careful out there. Then again, I'm sure no one's going to be looking for someone who's supposed to be dead. That's right. I'm the ghost. Ooh, can I buy another Mercury?
Welcome!
No. I see how it is.
It's uncommon nowadays.
Welcome back! But...
Oh yeah, dug up all sorts of dirt about Kana-chan, that is. Oh right, that's her childhood friend that had really disturbing parents that were exploiting her. Sexually. Oh boy. Are you free? I want to talk to you about it. Is that the one? I think it was. Yeah. Alright, let's see where this goes.
Thanks.
Come on over to my room then. I'll tell you there. Futaba's room is kind of like mine, but not as messy. It's probably the same type of size though. My room is really small as well. And I don't have a walk-in closet like she does. So I looked up Kana-chan online. She's apparently still living in the same town in Kansai she moved to. But she never continued on to high school. I decided to do some digging into what that might be, and well... The more I dug, the worse it got. Oh boy. Her parents are in heavy debt due to a gambling addiction. So instead of sending her to school, they made her work to help try and pay it off. Apparently they're still having her model in strange clothes. They're even selling the pictures now. Kill them? Okay, strange? How? Well, Definitely not the good type of strange. What horrible parents. Horrible is right. I thought parents were supposed to care for their children, not use them. You'd be surprised. Actually though, Kana-chan herself made a request on the fan site. Based on the IP and other tracking data, I'm 99.9% sure it's her. Okay, what about the 0.1%? The post was basically just her asking us to make her parents have a change of heart. But she didn't put their names. She may be a little hesitant, she doesn't totally believe in the Phantom Thieves yet. Most people don't want to also dox people too, let's keep that in mind. Either way, I have a solution.
I
found her parents' names in the address book we got way back in elementary school. Holy crap. Kota Magario and Asami Magario. Got a hit for them on the MetaNav too. We can fix them. I've decided, MC. I want to go to Mementos and change their hearts. Can't let them keep treating Kana-chan so horribly, right? Please help me save her. I'll do it for you.
Thanks.
Oh, and since you're gonna help me with this, I'll have to return the favor.
Oh, that's right.
I'll look extra hard for valuable stuff when we're in the metaverse. Yes. More money. Well, pretty good, huh? Okay, nice. Is it a request, or is it like the next time we hang out? Chance to revive search objects in the area after battle.
Right.
Oh wow. Like a double dip, huh? Well, I'll be counting on you. Let's save Kana-chan. Need to help Futaba put an end to this horrible parenting. Oh shoot, it's getting late. Let us adjourn for today. Oh no, it is a formal request, okay.
Bye now.
Well, that's nice. I don't know. Should I head into Mementos?
You're back.
Crap. That's a good question.
Now then.
So if I head in now, well, I don't know, like, once I clear Shido's palace, is there going to be, like, a big story section, or do I wait until the election period still? That's what I don't know. So, yeah. By the way, nothing to do but just keep hanging out with people. We are just living the quiet, incognito life. Yeah, it's just you guys, too.
Thank you.
Let's see. For today. For today, I want you to do a reading on me. A lot to show you today.
Here we go.
Look, mental training for sports. Oh, and building a successful business from the ground up. I even have a book about the secret to being a good listener. It was written by a hostess from a club in Ginza. Just picking out which books to bring took me half a day. I have tons more back home, though. I started using these as reference materials for the advice I give to my clients. This way I can suggest new alternatives instead of leaving them resigned to their fates. This, but she wants to hear this, so yeah. But yeah, that's a lot of free time to read all those books. Of course. After all, I need to be able to advise my clients on their future selves. Anyways, what I really wanted to tell you is that I've arrived at a new fortune-telling philosophy. Those with strong convictions can in fact change fate. Oh, and as for the people I sold holy stones to, I am going to issue a free refund. Fuck. I'd like to return the money they gave me too, but what? Did you spend? But what? I gotta hear this. Well, am I interrupting?
What?
Yokoda-san, let me guess, you're the villain of this confidant. It's been a while, maiden. What are you doing here? The chairman asked that I come see how things are going. Hmm? And who are you? That's my apprentice. I haven't actually introduced him to the chairman yet. You're telling me you're so busy you needed to hire an apprentice.
Yes,
he's been a wonderful help. I see. I guess I should have expected such great foresight from you, maiden. Now then, I should be going. Thank you for stopping by. Oh boy. far yet to see that. I am now a voodoo apprentice. Maiden. Okay, who is he? I suppose you could say he's an acquaintance. Anyways, it's a private matter, MC Sun. Nothing you should concern yourself with. Wait, are you perhaps worried about
me?
Thank you. Oh, I'm so touched, honestly. No. My luck really I will care for you once I get my 100k back. My luck really improves when you're around, MC Sun. I know. I'll return in return for that, I'll predict your luck whenever you want. Okay. I'll take it, fine. Rank 5. Deepens your bond with the confidant of your choice.
Alright.
Oh, it's like the fortune telling readings at the shrine in 4. Kinda too late for that though.
Oh well. Goodbye.
That's okay. And the 5th. Kechi-kun is so impressive. Can't believe he's still in high school. Did you watch that TV special about the heroes who took down the Phantom Thieves? I saw it too. It did make me like Akechi-kun more, but honestly now I'm a really big fan of Shido-san. I'd follow him no matter where he went if he was my boss. God, can't these people see past their own fat noses? They're crazier about Shido than ever. When I think about how he used us, damn it, pisses me right the hell off. Well, it'll be fine. The better his rep gets, the more I look forward to tearing it down. We'll make him own up to all this bullshit. Then, they'll see who the real heroes are. Damn right. Man, why do I always wait till after school to do stuff? Can I, like, use my mornings to do stuff now? If I don't go to school? Alright. Yusuke no Makoto, okay. Guess I'll just deepen with Yusuke then. Yeah.
Indeed.
Why?
The time is now, Yusuke. To go to Shido's palace? No, to hang out. Let's do it.
Well. Yes.
Where would we go? So we already went to the aquarium. We already went to the planetarium with EY. I go there with Ryuji, and I went to the shrine with him before. And I went to the bookstore with Pihaya. So let's go to Ueno. There's an art museum there. Yes, gazing upon the work of the masters. You have such interesting ideas.
Let us head off.
Let's be off.
Oh?
There are twice as many people here as there are normally. But the white noise caused by the crowd is quite pleasant. To be fair, it helps me own my senses. If I close my eyes, it's almost as if I'm floating through space. There's no sound in space. How to be a killjoy.
Indeed.
There's much to learn in observing the work of others. Interpretation depends on the state of the observer as well. It's as though art itself is alive. Honestly, I sense something has changed within me due to our visit here. It seems my attitude towards art has shifted in some way. Yes, I'd like to show you one of my favorite works. The piece that makes you see something new upon each visit is immensely rare. I look forward to viewing what I glean from it today, too. I hope you feel the same, MC.
To tell the truth,
the painting from earlier has actually been made into a statue. This may be a mere replica, but I would like you to have it. Get this shit out of my face.
Fascinating.
My artistic urges are flaring up. Let us return home. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's not the only thing flaring up.
Ah, you're back.
Okay. You made the right decision to confess. Now your trial should take your extenuating circumstances into account. Why did you suddenly decide to tell me? Because I wanted to eat katsudon.
For real?
Come on, that's why? Oh hey, did they give you katsudon to eat while you were in jail? No. I was injected with, like, drugs, that's what. Okay. Fine, I need to see what this is. Come on. Present from Yusuke, a replica of a sculpture at a museum. That must bring back memories of Ueno. Oh, I thought it would be like... I thought it would be like that type of nude statue, but no, it's that. Okay. Well, who is it now? Ifumi will go up. Oh nice, she actually goes up. Holy crap. That's amazing. Oh, but she didn't message me. Okay, I see how it is.
Good evening.
Can't teach you shogi right now, or rather from now on. I'm at checkmate right now, but my option is to concede. But I can't seem to give up. Not sure what my next move is after this checkmate. She seems troubled, but my knowledge is too strong. Okay.
What?
You'll help me think? Thank you. I am strong enough to think.
Actually,
before we play, I'd like to talk to you about something. My mother told me that I should lose my upcoming exhibition match against the pro. What do you mean? It's a strategy she devised. You'll get that if I lose to a man, I'll get sympathy from women, and as a result, get more female fans. That's when I make my comeback. I'll become a symbol for strong women everywhere. That way I can use the weekly magazine's popularity against them and instantly become famous. Maybe? I mean, that's quite a stretch to psychoanalyze a large aggregate of people. I mean, maybe that's true. Like, that depends. Maybe the mom like did research on the target demographic of average shogi like viewers and, you know, like how they act or how they would react. But still, it's quite a stretch. Measuring public opinion is something that can't really ever be predicted, despite companies and organizations predicting that. Like, yes, we have algorithms, of course, but they're not always 100% accurate, and I find it to be dangerous to always make very confident decisions like that. Don't think that will work, though. I wish I could agree, but I feel my mother may be right. People do love a good comeback story. Coming from the TV industry, my mother does have great insight for entertainment. But this time around, I couldn't help but argue. It's the wrong thing to do. Unethical, sure. I actually got into a fight with my mother. It wasn't the first time, though. What made me sad was, I realized my mother doesn't see me as a shogi player, but as an idol, right? She said that there's no need for me to be putting so much time and effort into shogi.
It's terrible.
Once I become a famous, I can quit shogi and make money from my looks. The only reason she continues to support my shogi career is so she can profit off me as an idol. She doesn't mind if I lose a match as long as I build my reputation and make money. To my mother, shogi is just a vehicle to make me famous.
However,
losing on purpose is wrong. Even if I help, if it helped me become famous and ease my parents' burden, I don't want to turn my back on shogi, a game that both my father and I love. Then let's make her reconsider. Only that were possible. She's the type of woman who never changes her mind. Based, strong women. We love strong women. Woo. She wants to achieve her unfulfilled dream of becoming a celebrity through me. I highly doubt she would ever reconsider. What's your mother's name? It's Mitsuyo Togo. What does that have to do with what we're talking about? Okay, need to do something about the target. Oh, nice. That's a fourth target. Excellent. I think we might actually go into Mementos now. Oh, and that was it. Wow, what a quick day. Campaign season's really heating up. Did you already decide who you're voting for? I see Shido's as popular as ever. Is there even any point in anyone else running? His approval rating went up again. How high will it go? How high would it go? You think Shido's gonna become the Prime Minister at this rate? With Akechi-kun and Shido-san, it feels like some heroes have been born this year.
Well.
That's right.
Begin?
The turning point of my era, of any era, is when a hero is born. They address everyone's fears and worries and skillfully carry out a revolution. Representative Shido is like that, don't you agree? A hero? Him? Don't make me laugh. This is getting really bad. We need to make everyone realize it. Well, I might if I get a day where I'm not doing anything. But I feel that's fastly approaching because, I mean, I can hang out with Shinya, but like, that's it, right? Oh, no, Makoto. But I still got plenty of days. But yeah, Shinya now, because now I can't hang out with Chihaya. No, no, never mind, I can. I cannot hang out with, damn, she won't go up. So I can't hang out with Hifumi anymore, because Memento's Request. I can only do Shinya now. Can't do EY, but Memento's Request. Chihaya. And Utaba, who's at 7. Yusuke, who will max. And Makoto, who's almost maxed. Yeah. So besides my 3 party members, I can only do Chihaya and Shinya. Sounds good. Okay. Let's spend some time with Makoto then. Makoto is taking a while to level up. Let's do it.
I see.
Train doors are now closing. Please stand back.
Where should I bring her today?
Yes.
We took her there last time. We can go to a ramen place. Harajuku? Did I take her there already? And then Tsukishima. Monjayaki. I'll take her to ramen. Why not?
Shall we go?
Flavor of that ramen is honestly addicting. Can't go wrong with noodles. Seems Makoto enjoyed herself. The delicious warmth of the ramen seems to be a source of comfort for her. Oh, no dialogue, okay.
Shall we return home?
I see. So, the food places are kind of hanging out.
You're back.
But taking them to the place that they would like an attraction, will prompt a gift. Okay. The election battle has reached the halfway point. The polls for each election ward have remained the same, though. Does this mean Shido's victory is guaranteed? That would be the case. I wonder if voting will shift if Shido has a change of heart. Nobody will vote for him once they find out he's a criminal. Assuming they find out before the vote. That's the important part. We would prefer him to announce his crimes before the election. If the change of heart doesn't make it, the election would go just as expected. We have to believe them. Yeah, I'm sure it'll happen beforehand. All we can do is change his heart. We should be able to put a stop to this if we succeed. So, it may seem. Let's go talk to her. But, I'm gonna see if I can first. Oh crap. Well, I wasn't planning on jumping right into it, because I was gonna see if I can get my bond deepened with someone. Oh well. That's fine. Recently, my reputation has really started shooting up. A lot of my clients leave happy now, too. I even managed to use my own powers to alter some fates that had once seemed inevitable. I suppose all you really need to change the fate is a strong will, like what you have. I wish I could do more, though. Are you on break now, Mifune-kun? Pompous, middle-aged man.
What?
Fukudai-san. So are you the apprentice I've heard so much about? I've been wondering, why are you so interested in Mifune-kun? That's a good one. I'm doing research for school. Well, we're trying to run a business here. Please finish this research of yours as soon as possible. That aside, I have to commend your judgment in choosing Mifune-kun. Your fortunes are like a light, guiding lost lambs throughout the unending darkness ahead. By the way, MC-san, this man here is Fukudai-san. He's, the chairman of the ADP. Okay, so he's the cult leader. Oh, right, you don't know, about the ADP yet. It stands for, I was gonna say something, but then I just realized right beside Fukudai is the theater, and it says Cult 9. And I was like, wow, that's uncanny. Assembly of the Divine Power. Great. Another Shuri PP cult. Our goal is to relive the hearts and minds of today's weary souls via healing events and seminars. We also sell holy stones, the well from which our divine power springs. They are a large part of our business. Fukudai-san, that reminds me, Yokoda-kun was telling me you've been acting a little strange recently. More importantly, it seems you started falling behind on your holy stones sales quota. Is everything okay? Yes, I'll cover the decrease in revenue with my fortune-telling fees. Fukudai-san, I'm not sure how effective these holy stones really are. Excuse me? Do you remember who showed you the way when you arrived here from the countryside, lost and confused? Do you remember who saved you when you were stuck working in a seedy club with no place to turn? It was me. Are you saying you no longer have trust in someone who's done so much for you? Damn, here comes the gaslighting. That's not it. Then enough of the skepticism. Just focus on continuing your role as the Maiden of Relief. Read the fortunes of those unfortunate souls who come to us and lead them to salvation with the Holy Stones. Quite the joke. There is no salvation for those who joke. You don't want things to go back to how they were, do you, Mifune-kun? Don't you remember breaking down in front of me, telling me how everyone called you a monster? If you don't carry your weight as the Maiden of Relief, you'll be exactly that. A monster. Bro. Bro? Leave her alone. Fine, if you want to spend your time fooling around with this child, go right ahead. But don't forget, Mifune-kun, the ADP is the only place you will ever belong. Talk about a manipulator, huh? Never actually worked at a nightclub. I did get tricked into walking into one, though. Anyways, the chairman is known for exaggerating details. You must think I'm weird, huh? All this talk about me being a maiden or a monster? You're just Chihaya to me.
What?
Huh? Nobody's ever treated me so nicely before.
But...
the way, it was pretty amazing how we stood up to the chairman back there. I would never have been able to talk to him about the Holy Stones had I been alone. But your strength helped me speak up. I need to be strong like you more often. Okay. Rank 6.
All right.
Now if I can slowly get Chihaya's Mementos request, I'll have 5. And I think then I'll be good to go into Mementos. The chairman seems serious about the whole Holy Stone issue. He'll make me pay a fine if I don't meet my quota. There's a huge penalty for resigning from my post. Ooh, there's also Makoto's Mementos request, now that I think about it. Because I'm obviously probably going to have to go after Tsukasa too. So yeah, that'll be 6 Mementos request. Yeah, maybe I'll save them up. I suppose my fate is impossible to change after all. Anyways, I should close up for today.
Until next time!
Sounds good. Sorry about today. I already know what I must do in order to change my fate. Whenever I face the chairman, I just can't find the courage to say what I need to. We'll work on it then. I mean, that makes me happy, but I feel like it's not good for me. I don't want to have to keep relying on you. Because you're weak. I'm going to think about all this a little more. Thank you once again for today. I'll see you next time. Maybe you need a holy stone, Chihaya. Maybe you need like 10 holy stones. I'll sell you mine. Oh wait, it's disintegrated.
Hey.
Okay. Yusuke's having enough of my shit. They want me to work? Okay. Got it. Oh? Oh, is today the day? Today is the day. Yep, today is the day. All right. I'll cut this one early then in that case, and we will head into... Whoops. I keep pressing the wrong one. Yeah. We'll head into the palace, because, it's fine. For the mementos request, I'm about to get Chihaya's request, I'm pretty sure. I'm about to get Makoto's request, I'm also pretty sure, so there's no reason to do them until I can, but I'm not gonna pass up today to do it. So yeah, we'll gather the crew, and we'll head in next time.
Let's do it.
Wait, wrong. I want to gather the crew first. Not yet.
Okay.
That's everyone.
Even the web is fanboying all over Shido. Gotta snap him out of it real soon. Oh, that's cool. We're all hanging out here now. Ryuji, you're making me nervous. He's going to give himself a concussion like that. Alright.
Hey!
We're going to do a request now? Isn't that somewhat dangerous? You really can't let people suffer, huh? I'll come too if you're going, MC. Today seems like a perfect day for us to go into Mementos. Let me check our intel. Start with this one first.
Listen up.
This intel is on a foul young man who scams the elderly with all sorts of fraudulent businesses. At this point, he's expanded his crime into a larger organization.
I'm gonna make him pay.
That's bullshit. Can't forgive someone who's been taking advantage of old people. Gotta take that bastard down and make sure nobody else ends up getting scammed by him. I hate people like that. Let's destroy them. There are still more.
Listen up.
This is from the owner of the Central Street Airsoft Shop. Apparently an acquaintance is threatening him. The acquaintance, Tsuda, is a professional. If we don't hurry, EY will be in serious danger.
The hell?
That man's pretty freaking scary. In any case, this time we're going up against a real criminal. He'll be a worthy opponent. Seems tough, but I think we can accomplish this if you say we can.
Nice!
Looks like we're all ready to do this. I already left the calling card.
Listen up!
This intel is on a stage mother who mistreats her daughter, the shogi player Hifumi Togo. She controls every aspect of Hifumi's career, and has thus ruined her daughter's shogi life. She forced Hifumi to become an idol against her wishes, and even plans to fix her upcoming shogi match.
That's...
She's treating her daughter like some kind of tool. We have to release Hifumi from that state.
Very well.
Yusuke's like, oh, my classmate. Very well. I will go along with this. Alright.
Listen up.
And the final intel is on the parents of Futaba's friend, Kana. They forced Kana to take immoral jobs so that they can pay off their debt. Ever since she was young, they've trampled over her life. I'm gonna crush them. I'll save Kana-chan.
Nice!
Oh god.
Yep.
Alright, you know what that sounds? Nice! Got it all done. Let's hold a meeting, and we're good.
Now then.
At this rate, Shida will indeed become the next Prime Minister. We must prevent that. A man like him has no right to lead. We must change his heart before the election day arrives.
Okay, time for the meeting.
What now? There's still much we don't know. Why don't we investigate it further first? Be extra careful about the guard shadows. Getting beaten to a pulp is the last thing we need now. Feels like we're kind of OP. We should be totally fine.
Okay.
I believe that's it.
That concludes our meeting.
Sounds good. Let's head it.